Potentiometers, or POTS, as well as trimmers and rheostats, are frequently confused as they're very similar. But don't stress about it too much, people know what you're talking about most of the time, though more precision in language will help. So a potentiometer or a trimmer is usually referring to a voltage divider. Now, potentiometers are usually bigger and easy to adjust, so it's for things where you anticipate wanting to change it frequently. Whereas when you get a trimmer, typically refer to things that are smaller and flatter, and you typically have to have a screwdriver to adjust it. But internally, it's about the same. Rheostats are usually the same thing as POTS or trimmers physically, but are called rheostats when they're acting as variable resistors instead of voltage dividers. So to keep things simple, I'll refer to all of them as potentiometers or POTS from here on out. So there are a couple of different symbols that are used, but all of them have three connection points. I'm going to use this slightly larger potentiometer as a good example, and that is you typically have an input, an output, and then a wiper, and they can be in different areas, and they can have different names as well. It could be terminal 1 or terminal A, terminal 2 or B, wiper terminal. So there's a bit of variation in the language that's used, but almost always there are three connection points, as you can see on this potentiometer, and even on this trimmer, you can see just three plugs. So potentiometers, what is happening is, as you're turning it, you are getting either a linear or a logarithmic change in the resistance between the different points. Now, I say linear or logarithmic. The difference between the two is called the taper, and that is really how much you change this versus how much the output changes. Now, that may seem strange, like why would I ever want anything that's not linear? Why would I want something that's logarithmic? But the time when you'd want something that's logarithmic is when you're dealing with something like sound or brightness, whereas a doubling of sound and a doubling of brightness does not double our sensation of it. It's logarithmic. So you have to go 10 times brighter for us to see basically a doubling of the brightness. So that's where logarithmic potentiometers and trimmers are great. So this potentiometer actually has a linear taper, and I want to show I have one hooked up here to two multimeters, and they're both sharing the center terminal. So as I change the potentiometer, you will see how it changes from currently, I have 1.4, 1.3 ohms on one, and then almost 10 kilo ohms on the other. As I turn it, okay, the one on the left, the fluke just jumped up to 1, and the one on the right is now 9. And you will see that the resistance between the center terminal and the outside terminals is changing, and it's almost like they're giving the other one that resistance. And I'll show you why physically that is happening later. But the one on the left went from practically zero resistance to, as I go all the way up, it'll go all the way up to 10 kilo ohms. Whereas the one on the right, which started at 10, is now down to 1.2, 1.3 ohms. And so that is what happens with a linear potentiometer, is that you can see as you twist it, the resistance that is seen by these ohmmeters changes. So what's happening there is I have this one. I took it apart. It's actually, these things are pretty darn simple. What is going on? There's only really four pieces that come apart easily on this, and then another piece that I guess you could technically say is a separate piece. So five pieces total to this entire thing. So you can see right here, this is the top part, and you have the plastic knob that comes out. It's got a little bit of grease in there just to make it so it slides properly. And then this interesting contact point, which makes a lot of sense once we look at the bottom. But then we just have that, and that's just an enclosure to hold it together. Now, all of this makes a lot more sense once we look at this right here. I almost feel like I should be using some, there we go. Here, this is better to point with. So this spot right here is highly conductive. This spot right here is highly conductive, whereas this black section is not quite as conductive. It's very specific conductance. I think you can assume that the entire thing from here to here is about 10,000 ohms. And then as the wiper slides around the outside, it changes the conductance or the resistance of the entire potentiometer. And then the other side is going through more or less depending on what the first side is doing. So it's kind of interesting how that all works. The one in the middle, that's a constant low resistance material right there. And then as the wiper right here, as these points slide along here, it changes the internal resistance. And that is how a physical potentiometer or trimmer works, which is pretty interesting. Now, if we are to look at other things, there are such things as digital potentiometers. And all that is basically they get a bunch of resistors put together, and then you say, all right, I want this resistance, and it'll close switches or open switches to get the resistance that you want. So all that is an array of resistors of sometimes the same value, sometimes different values, and then they open and close switches to give you exactly what you want. So that's how a digital potentiometer works. So those are the two types of potentiometers and trimmers that you have, are the mechanical, where you're physically sliding around, and then the digital, which is literally just opening and closing of switches. So that's it. That's our basic overview of potentiometers and trimmers. I hope you found that interesting. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave it in the section below, or you can go to our website at circuitbread.com and ask any questions there, or reach out to us. And we hope that you enjoyed this. If you did, please like this video and subscribe to our channel.